Hi guys, it's me, Wussey,
and Richard.
And guess what we're doing today? We actually don't know yet.
Oh, right, yeah. No, I thought you had a plan and I was like, huh?
Oh, no. I think the plan is still what we said about going around some Disney hotels and things like that, but we don't know officially. So that is TBC, not to be confused with IDK, which is I don't know.
Oh, well done. That's
TBC, to be confirmed. True. Or to be continued. But I'm just doing a little like intro vlog now because we're having a nice lazy chill out morning. But the most important thing is you need to see the action that is going on over here. Sorry, my wobbly camera work. I've set the princesses up. I've set the princesses up with a puzzle. They're not allowed to let go of their ends and they've got to work out how to detangle themselves. There's been quite a few times when one of them's let go, so I've had to reset the game. But they're trying to work out how to get out. And it's quite funny, the positions that they're getting themselves into. Oh no! We didn't know it would be this entertaining, especially when Florence tries to just spin around and,
okay, we're back
here. Oh, well done! You're back to the start! You've achieved nothing.
Wait.
The thing is, what the girls don't know is I don't actually know the answer. I know that it can be done. I know that it is a solution, but what the solution is, I don't actually know myself. So we will have to Google it. Oh, I think she may have heard me. But yes, they've been playing sharks and mermaids. So the shark is allowed in here, but the mermaids can run into their cove and they can be safe in there. And they've set up, there's a seaweed camera. So the camera keeps an eye on them to make sure that there's no cheating going on. So that's the game they've been playing this morning. And yes, now they're just working out how to do this, and I think it may take a while. But anyway, if you're not a subscriber already, then please do subscribe to the channel. That would mean the world. Give me a thumbs up if you like the video. Turn on your notifications so you get an update every time there's a new video. I'm here for 3 weeks of magical fun. Yay! Drop me a comment. I'd love to hear from you. And also, I am on Instagram @wussey_. It will be written somewhere in the corner. But yes, we're off for a magical day, but we just don't know what quite yet. That's really good, girls. Keep it up. Yes, good girls. Keep going. Keep going. Nearly there.
There is
no solution. Yes, keep going. Oh, yes. Try spinning and then stepping through each other. Yes, good. That's it. Spin. Now go through. Yeah, oh, don't let go. Pick that up. That's cheating. Go through. Yeah, keep going. Don't change hands. Nearly there.
Spin.
Family! 3, 2, 1, we're in Walt Disney World! We've never been before in our whole lives! Apart from every day at the minute. Ooh, can you work out where we are? Can you work it out? It's somewhere we've not been in a long time. Let me know if you recognize this little hut. It says, welcome home. Right, we are in. We didn't know if we were gonna get charged for parking, but all we did is show ID and we got let in. But we're coming up. Guest check-in is to the left and buses only is to the right, so we're gonna go left. Do you recognize these rooftops? Let me know in the comments if you've worked it out. But we're getting closer. I'm very excited. I've not been here in a very, very long time. But yes, we're trying to work out where to go. Check-in is straight ahead. Self-parking is left. Follow that car, Oh, and look who's coming. Mike Wazowski and Sully. Hello. That's where the Disney transportation will pick you up if you are staying here. But yes. This is the Fort Wilderness Lodge.
Disney Hotel, a deluxe resort. Stop at the stop and then go when you can go. Right, it says, pardon our pixie dust. This area is being refurbished for your future enjoyment. This is the logo, Disney's Wilderness Lodge. There's bears on it. But as we come up here, we'll have to look up and see what refurbs are going on. But yeah, this building is very, very big, my darlings. Big, green and brown lodge. So Wilderness Lodge, I was just explaining to the girls, the theme of it is, yeah, that we're kind of like in the wilderness, I guess. Kind of how I imagine, if you've ever watched The Parent Trap with Lindsay Lohan, when they go on like summer camp, it's like a big lodge version of that, I guess. There's campfires, you can ride horses here, there's like stables and things like that. I'll turn you around. Now, there's two parts to it. So this is the actual Wilderness Lodge, which is like the big, grand Disney hotel, all themed to the wilderness, just can cross the road safely. And then also there's the Fort Wilderness campgrounds. So don't get confused. When we were driving in, there was two different entrances. So one of them, if you want to go to Fort Wilderness campgrounds, look out for the word campgrounds on the signpost, and you'll almost feel like you're driving to the right. You'll drive towards the Magic Kingdom parking entrance, and that's how you'll go up that way to the campgrounds. We actually went left of the Magic Kingdom parking entrance. We went left, followed the signs for the Magic Kingdom resorts. Resorts would mean Contemporary Resort, Grand Floridian Resort, Polynesian Resort, and the Fort Wilderness Lodge. There's like those four big resorts. There's probably some other ones, but they're the four that I can remember off the top of my head. So we went left of the Magic Kingdom parking entrance. Follow that, almost follow the signs if you're going to a Contemporary Resort. But before you get to a Contemporary Resort, you'll see a sign, turn right, and that brings you into the Wilderness Lodge. So we're heading in this way. Here is where you drop your car off. Bit kind of like compassy style design maybe on the right, but we're heading in this way here. Woo! Here's the Wilderness Lodge mat, big wooden doors. As we come in, I've seen this on YouTube quite a few times and it looks absolutely amazing, so I'm hoping that it's still as impressive in real life. Oh, the answer is yes. Look, she's taking pictures already. Wow, it's absolutely massive. Yeah, it's huge. Yeah, Katie just said like Pocahontas style. It is like a massive, lots of like dark woods is the theming. Oh yeah, yeah, Animal Kingdom Lodge inspired. Well, actually this was before Animal Kingdom Lodge, if you've stayed there. Whispering Canyon Cafe. But yeah, wood, log beams, although those big doors that we just came in. What do you think, Florence? Is it big? Is it really big? Where do they stay and sleep? Oh, good question. Well, there's going to be lots of bedrooms all the way up and round, all the outsides. See how high it goes up there? Lots of rooms there. But yeah, this is like their main entranceway. Very tall, isn't it? Yeah, very tall. It looks like check-in is maybe on that side over there. And yes, then there's the cafe over here. Oh, and if you do want to stay at the Fort Wilderness campgrounds, then you stay in lodges. I probably won't do it justice. I imagine it's more like, you know, if you ever go like Centre Parks and you all have like your own cabins outside in the like campgrounds in the wilderness in the forest, it's almost like Disney's version of that on a much, much grander scheme. It's Chip and Dale. But yes, big grander scale. But yes, I've lost the family. Oh, but look at this absolutely massive. Is it a totem pole? Is that what I call it? It's huge. It's so big. They've got pin trading over there, I saw on the board as well. Yeah, but lots of things going on. I have a feeling Amelia's looking for the toilet. And also, if you do stay at Disney Hotel, you do get your free Walt Disney World transportation, so you can follow the signs. They've got a health club, bus transportation, Cubs Den and Game Arcade, Boulder Ridge Villas. They've got villas. Oh, and look! A Disney totem. There. And there's a gift shop in here, Wilderness Lodge Mercantile. Oh, which of the group's going in? I love the way they present this like beach towel. It's like in a frame, so you can stroke it and see all the design on it rather than it folded up. Oh, you can actually get the wilderness totem pole there. the Disney version. Oh yes, this is very Wilderness Lodge, isn't it, darlings?
Yes.
What's good is you'll find merchandise in the Disney hotels that are kind of themed to the hotel that you're staying in. So if you want to get some Disney merch that is not, you know, Magic Kingdom or Epcot related, you can find things that are themed to your hotel. Very, very unique, very clever. Oh, look up here. We've got a cat. Oh, she wants a toy. She's asking for a toy already, of course she is. Yes, so I love all the beams and everything as well. Oh, I just saw that, which did go back. I thought it was quite nice.
$65,
honey.
Nice.
Yeah. Wow, I don't know if the video will do it justice, but look how like shimmery this throw is. Yes, Princess Amelia. What have you found? I can't hear you. Oh, the pins. Oh, loads of pins.
And then here.
Yeah.
They've got packs of them.
Oh yes, all different things. Zootopia ones, Muppets, Disney villains. What's this one here? Happiness. Oh, it's a mystery pin. That one. Oh, and look at all the hats. So all the hats over here. The classic. You've got all of the ears. Classic caps as well. You've got all of your Disney headbands, your mini ears and your Mickey ears. You've got a Halloween section. What have you found, which to go up? Oh, a drinking bottle of flask.
I love the effect.
Oh, because it's like a wooden. Oh, it's
But it's not wooden.
I like the feeling. No, it's wooden, but not wooden. Yes, I like that very much. Oh, it's got the animals up here. Yes, and of course, because it's August, we start celebrating Halloween here a lot earlier than we would in the UK. Oh, hello. Where am I? There. Hello, me. Oh, and then this is like more like the game section, the toy section. Oh, I like these bags. Down here, the lounge flies. Oh, powered by light. Any light never needs a battery. Some eco watches are there. Oh, we've got some Pandora.
Mommy told me to speak to you.
Disney's Pandora. So if you want your jewellery, you've got that. Oh, it keeps going. We've got a whole home section here. Witchy Gov's always looking at the mugs and cups and glasses and things. Yes, very, very good. Uh-oh, we're in trouble. Witchy Gov has found the Pop-Tarts and he's found the snacks. Yes? Yes, what would you like? Where are you taking me? She's taking me somewhere. I presume this means she's going to use me emotionally. We're playing catch it, keep it. Okay, catch it, keep it. What are we playing catch it, keep it with? Show me. With all of these? With the Mickey? Okay, who's going to throw it? Does Mummy want to throw it? Catch it, keep it. Good luck. Are you nervous? Are you excited? Here we go. Catch it, keep it. You are so good at this game. How do you feel? Speechless. Woo, yeah. Mickey's all yours from Fort Wilderness. Yeah. That's something I never thought about at the Disney hotels. Yeah, you can actually buy Disney baby pushchair. So that's really useful for the parks. Here we go. Katie's just found, what is it, a brand new bracelet?
Yeah, this is definitely a new one.
I like all the colours on it.
I love it.
Woo, very gorgeous. Nice. Richard, you go up. I've just found something for you for our new house. Get to work!
I don't think so.
Richard Grubb just had a random woman from the UK come up to him, and what did she say?
Morning!
She said, morning!
Yes.
She's a big Adam Hatton fan as well, so we were chatting about YouTube and, you know, what you do when you see them out and about, and I said, oh, I saw Jack from DSNY Newscast at Animal Kingdom the other day, and I freaked out, but then I didn't want to be too intrusive, so then I ran away. So, yes. So we love wearing, like, the YouTube tops. It's nice to meet people out and about as well. They kind of have the same passion and same level of enjoyment as Disney and of YouTube as we do. Uh-oh, where are we going?
My turn.
Amelia's turn for catch it, keep it.
My turn.
Okay. Where are we going?
I'm going to stand here.
Okay. Jewelry, careful. Yeah! You got it. I don't even know what it is.
These earrings.
Oh, Minnie Mouse earrings. Yeah. Very nice, darling. Well, now they're yours. Yay! Well, like, look at these as well. You know, if you want to get the big lollipops, these are lollipop savers. So you can open them up and put those massive Mickey-shaped lollies inside and save it for another day. This has been needed for years. Very good invention. You can get the Evil Queen box with Disney's Wilderness Lodge theming. I also like, I stopped because I saw these, like giant Wilderness Lodge mugs. I can't take the lid off because it's attached at the minute, but yeah, like lids. I thought they looked like little acorns, or well, big acorns really. We've got a big grizzly bear here, but the reason I stopped is this bag. This bag is ace. Is this Loungefly? Yes, this is Loungefly. I thought that was really good. I'd say I'm bigger than the other Loungefly bags. I don't really use the Loungefly bags because of their size, but these ones are big. And again, yeah, I love the theming. Like I said, to get stuff that's a bit more exclusive because it's themed to a Disney hotel, I think it's very good. A robe as well, darlings. Oh, it's like a different feel on the outside from like a typical dressing gown. And then fleecy on the inside. And there's also some Wilderness Lodge Mickey's. Mickey's riding on a horse there. And Donald is not too far behind. So we've come out of the shop and we're coming over here. There's a list of all of the different activities you can do. You can scan the QR code. Buttons and Bells game in the arcade. Wonders of the Lodge art and architecture tour. Tasteful artistry at Disney's Wilderness Lodge. Lots of activities down there for different days. There at Wilderness Lodge, correct. They've got a picture with the Disney totem pole. Poolside activities, craft of the day, different things. Oh, it's Mickey tie-dye. Yes, they have a campfire here, so that's amazing. And the movie Under the Stars, where you can sit with, I think you sit with Chip and Dale, and you sit outside, and you can watch Winnie the Pooh, Richard's favorite, Encanto, Enchanted, Beauty and the Beast, Wish, The Greatest Showman, and then a mystery movie on a Saturday. And then also they've got the directory here. So there you go, you see the dining options here. Whispering Canyon Cafe, we saw that as we came in. Geyser Point Bar and Grill. Roaring Fork, they do breakfast, lunch and dinner. What's the Territory Lounge, number 7? Oh, that's for the map downstairs. There's shopping. So you've got Wilderness Lodge Mercantile that we went into. Entertainment, there's Fire Rock Geyser, which is, it's located near here. The Hidden Mickey Hunt. Ooh, I love Hidden Mickey Hunts. And then more recreation here. Copper Creek Springs, outdoor pools and spas. Health Club, Boulder Ridge Cove, outdoor pool and spa. Reunion Station, oh, that's for the Disney Vacation Club, DVC, member recreation services, and the bus depot. And there is a map here, so you can see. I presume we came in this way, because this is the car park, so we came in, so we've got all of this big green bit to explore. Are these like villas or lodges or something on the other side? Or the pools. We're on the edge of Seven Seas Lagoon, so you can get a boat. And then this one's go down to like the campground area, I'm presuming. I've not been in here in a very long time. Oh yes, and it says there, 7 is Territory Lounge. So when I go on here, I look at number 7, and I now know the Territory Lounge is there. Now where's everyone gone? Where have they gone, Daddy?
We've gone to the arcade.
Oh, we've gone to the arcade out this way. We're following the floor. Not that you have to, but we're just very silly. We're following the floor in the, back in the lobby area, because we're heading to the restroom in the corner. So yes, we're playing the game. The big kids can play too. Oh, got to squeeze by there. That's it, jump over the edge. Heading to the restrooms back at the cafe, so near the entrance. Toilet time. It says here, when you spot the Chip and Dale photo prop, take a picture with them and head to the front desk for a button. So we'll have to keep an eye out. So, whilst the girls are in the arcade, we nip for a wee-wee, as you do, and we've come to the front desk because we know, I don't know if you can see very well, there's a hidden Mickey hunt What we didn't know is there's two. So I've got the one which is going to give us clues for the hidden Mickeys that are in the main lodge, where we are now. And you've got the one for...
the Boulder Ridge Villas are just located outside the back.
Yes, there's two. So we can do the main lodge and we can do Boulder Ridge. It's completely free. If we, there's different clues. He said that some of them are quite tricky. So we are going to have to work really hard to get this. We've got some free little pencils, like the ones you get at like a mini golf to keep score. We're going to fill in the answers. And he says if we find everything, we're going to come back, show it here, and then we'll see what we get. But of course, that's if we complete it. So
no pressure.
Are you up for the challenge?
Let's do this.
Woo! Let's go tell the girls. So we found the girls. Hey girls, would you like to do the hidden Mickey hunt? Girls? Rude. Right, so coming out from that way, our first time coming outside of it. Oh look, Buttons Bells Game Arcade. Buttons and Bells Game Arcade.
Welcome.
Oh, welcome, welcome, welcome. Oh look. It's the Lazy Boys. Lads. We can't tell you. We've been very secretly doing something. Hello. Oh, look. It's Florence's Mickey.
Oh, I'm squeezing.
Is it good? Is it good? Do you have to pay for it?
Yeah.
How much was it?
$5 for 12 and a half minutes.
For 12 and a half minutes? $5 for 12 and a half minutes. You look like you're going through something, whereas Paul looks like chilled.
Paul's not.
Oh, okay, that's why. Where is everyone? There you are. I can't hear you.
Have you got some money to put anything?
Have I got some money? I thought you were going to pay. I thought. Wait, I thought you were going to pay for the whole holiday. Hey, girls. We have something to tell you. What? Katie?
She's going to go and get the tokens.
Oh, she's going to get tokens. I'll tell you in a bit. Okay, bye. Oh, so I've not seen this before. So you need to get an arcade card to play. You've done what? Spent
$10? I spent $10, which gives me 600 points.
$10 to get 600 million points. So I heard. Oh, like a recharge station. Okay, I guess it's so you're not giving kids all the money.
You don't always need a new card. You already have one, but I don't, so I requested new cards.
Okay, let's go play. Yay! Okay, wow. I think someone may be excited. Ah, look. Now Paul's not looking so brave.
It
now
really
he's
hurt.
Does it hurt?
My shoulder blades in agony there.
Oh. But does that, it's released something,
no, it
right?
Really dug in.
Really dug in. Oh no, look at that face.
It squeezes.
At least it's working, you're getting your money's worth. They're on, they're racing. Oh, I thought they're racing against each other.
I don't know how to drive.
You don't have to drive? You really shouldn't be behind the wheel, madam. Quickly go, oh look, can we go on the Ferris wheel?
I've got pedals.
So yeah, when you get your voucher, the card, in case you've got, all you have to do is swipe it through and it tells you how many points you've been charged and how many points are left. So this is 60 points. So you just swipe the card and then you can play the game. Okay, so we're going to go on a motorbike.
Yeah, orange is Florence's favourite colour, so we're on an orange bike.
Orange bike, yeah.
Tells us with 80 points. Swipe. It should flash green, tells me how many I've got remaining. Yes, I'm going to use them and play.
And here we go. I hope you've got your driver's license, Florence. Oh my God. Look how big it is for her. Go, Florence, go! Do you know what you look like right now? One of those little dolls on It's a Small World. When they shake with the grass skirts. Really, really good. So I'm suddenly feeling really old because I haven't told the girls yet about the hidden Mickey hunt, but of course they're in there playing all the games. And am I now that person that thinks that, you know, a piece of paper and a pencil type game, like a hunt, is more exciting than the arcade? Because I used to be the kid that would love the arcade, and of course I still love arcades, but now I feel like I'm actually going to ruin their time by going in and saying, hey kids, let's go do this. Is this a bit more old school? I mean, yes it is, but I find it really exciting. So I haven't told them yet, I'm just patiently waiting. If I turn you around, you can see the outside of some of the rooms. These are their balconies, my darlings, and we're in the wilderness. So yes, there's a tree. In fact, there's many trees. I don't know if that's Boulder Ridge over there, that building, because I don't know this hotel very well at all. It's very peaceful, it's very quiet. Unless you go in there, then of course it's very, very noisy. But yeah, I'm just kind of waiting. Let's see if they spend all their vouchers, and then I can see if I can get them interested in the hidden Mickey hunt. So Liv's doing the snow cross. Amelia's on super bikes too, and all she's doing is crashing into the wall. So Liv's a lot better. Well done, darling, well done. Where did you grow up? Would you be interested in my old school hidden Mickey hunt? Can I sign you up?
Yes!
Yay! You wanted to do it with me? Okay, here's your pencil.
Thank you.
Okay, good luck. Hey girls, do you wanna do a hidden Mickey hunt? No, that's not good. Girls, guess what? Big surprise! I've got a paper and pad and we're gonna find Mickey's. What do you think? No, that's not cool.
It's me, Mickey Mouse. Would you like to find me in a hidden Mickey hunt? You would?
I knew you'd be here for me, Mickey. You're my best friend. We're out. Yes, good, Liv. Girls, meeting. Girls, come over here, quick. Come this way. Who wants a surprise?
Me.
Okay, here you go. Take this. Okay. Take this. Okay. Oof. Take this. What is it?
Hidden Mickey hunt.
We're going to go round. We're going to go back inside, follow the clues, and we've got to find the hidden Mickeys. I'm going to give you a pencil you can write your names on. Hope you remember what your names are. If not, then maybe make up a really cool name. Yes, Brenda.
Brenda.
There you go, Liv. There you go. So you can write your names on and we're going to go find hidden Mickeys. Yay!
Yay!
Woo! Okay, I think it's working. So clue one, a hint one.
I didn't know how to spell witchetigwood, by the way.
That's fine.
Thank
you. In the lobby, colours abound, pressed into the rock is where I am found. Near the corner, look up high, this place will keep you warm and dry. Let's go find it!
Let's go!
Yay!
Woo! Go! Run! Florence! Oh no, my plan has all gone wrong. I set my alarm to go off at 12:58, so I have 2 minutes to get ready. The plan was, essentially with the virtual queues, they released some more at 1 p.m. So we've done the ones at 7 a.m. and they'd gone. And I thought with a bit of Wilderness Lodge, I could surprise them with joining the virtual queue for Tron or for Tiana's Bayou Adventure. And as it's got to 1 o'clock, I refreshed and I thought, oh, we could join the virtual queue. But you have to sort out who's in your party. And I thought, that's weird, it doesn't come with who's in our party. And the reason is, if I can click edit, when you go on, it says that none of us are eligible for it because you have to be in the park. You have to be actually physically in the park, which of course we're not. You have to be in the park to get your virtual queue. Also, this is very, very blurry. So, no surprise. So I'll have to go break the news. Now they're gonna think that I'm fibbing when I say I didn't get to virtual queue. Because my dad is in on it, and Wichita Grub is in on it. He knows that there's a plan. So now I'm going to say I didn't get one. And of course, they're going to think I'm lying, because I did that with Cosmic Rewind. But I'm actually telling the truth. We can't get one. But let's join this then. So we're not going to be going into Magic Kingdom. And we're looking for a hidden Mickey somewhere up on this fireplace. Let's see if we can find one. We found it. It's really quite hard to see, so I'm going to try and show you. If I zoom in, where the wooden beam comes out, it's going to be in the middle of the screen. Can you see the Mickey shape? Right in the middle of the bang centre, you'll see a circle and then two ears. It's never like really, really, really crystal clear because that's the whole reason for it being hidden. But that is a hidden Mickey. It's called a classic Mickey because if you just drew through three circles, that'd be how you'd, you know, represent Mickey Mouse. And it's there, all the way up on the fireplace, hidden away. That's how high the fireplace goes. And it's right there at the fireplace. Yes, have you written it down?
Red brick at end of first beam.
Yes, oh, you have to write where it is. Okay, what's the next one?
You'll find Mickey driving a bus high above the rest of us in a sign that shows the way where you can work out or play.
Okay. So we're looking for a sign that says where you can work out and play. Well, this says about the arcade.
Where's Mickey driving the bus?
Oh, that's what we need then. Where's Mickey driving the bus?
You'll find Mickey driving a bus. This is Mickey, the transportation bus.
Yeah. Oh, that's the Mickey. So he's there. He's there. That's the hidden Mickey. That is Mickey. See him there. He's driving the bus. And that's the hidden Mickey there. That one was easier then. They said suddenly he's just about, you'll find Mickey driving the bus. And yes, I didn't notice it before. It's just a very long bus. And Mickey is driving it. Yay! Okay, number three, it says we have to go outside. What does it say, Amelia?
She blows faithfully each day on the hour. If you stand too close, she'll give you a shower.
Someone's going to give us a shower if we stand too close? Who's that?
Is that yeah.
What I've could it be? Idea.
Could it be in the pool?
It does say outside, so we need to go outside.
Geyser.
Oh, it could be a geyser. Should we go out this way? I'll show you. I think there's one here. Let's go outside. Well, this looks like the bottom of a geyser, but I don't think this is fun. Amelia, go over the bridge. We're going over the bridge for absolutely no reason other than pure Disney magic. Here we go, up and over. Oh, yeah, glimpses outside. A bubble machine.
Yeah, like she blows faithfully each day on the hour.
Yeah, that blows bubbles. Could be.
Maybe in that room, that won't give you a shower though.
True, not a shower. So we need a more showery, blowy thing.
Maybe a waterfall?
Maybe a waterfall. Let's have a look. I did think this would be like a, sorry, I feel like I'm being quite boring because I'm trying to, I don't know, you know, like trying to have fun with the kids, but also you're going like, this is also like a secret way of getting you to like tour it and be interested in it. When we said before that like, we're going to view a Disney hotel, the kids were like, oh wow, that sounds boring. I was like, well, it's not like a Premier Inn or a travel lodge, like it's like a proper nice hotel. So I was like, oh, I hope this isn't too boring of an idea, but are you liking it?
Yeah.
Yeah. So, any clues here? I can see a clue.
Geyser point.
Yeah, follow the signs, let's go to the geyser. Geyser point. Follow the geyser point, follow Wichity Club. Down there, oh wow.
I've heard it.
Look down there. That's where the swimming is. Loads of rooms. It's absolutely mahoosive. The rest of the family's coming. Hello! Oh, we're gonna go down here. Yeah. Oh yes, there's a waterfall there. I don't think that's gonna get us wet though. It doesn't necessarily like blow. Which way? Geyser Point. I still think Geyser Point, so we're gonna turn right and go towards Geyser Point Bar and Grill. Oh, but it's very nice. I thought this was a swimming pool, so this is more just like a nice water feature. There's the swimming pool. The water flows down there. Oh, there's kids queuing, so I wonder if there's a slide. Yes, because they're running. Yes, follow the signs for Geyser Point. Oh, so this is called Copper Creek Springs. So this is one of the Disney pools. There's the slide. People coming up the slide. This is one of the Disney pools here at Fort Wilderness Lodge. Oh, and this is called, what's this called? Humphrey's Hideout. Humphrey's Hideout at Disney's Wilderness Lodge. So you can get some like snacks and stuff there, I presume. Where's Geyser Point gone? This way to Geyser Point, so keep going. Gonna keep following the kiddos and Wichita Club. See if we find it. It's quite a big gap, isn't it, between the main lodge and coming out this way. So they're making us get our steps in. So it says, we're looking for a hidden Mickey, but we have to find it at the geyser. I think it's at the geyser because it says it. She blows on the hour. So a geyser is when the water goes psh, and it does that, but it only does it on the hour. So we don't know exactly where the geyser is because it's now about quarter past one. So that's Geyser Point Cafe. But yeah, we're thinking it's somewhere here, but we don't know where. Have you broken your pencil? Have you managed that? What did you do? You pushed too hard. Yes. Oh look, I think maybe, are these deer tracks or bear prints? I'm not sure. But some sort of animal has crossed the way. Of course, that's the Disney magic. It's not actually real, my darlings. Yeah, this one is proving really tricky. We were looking in the wrong place. We've come round. Look to the right here. So this must be the geyser that comes out there. And if I zoom in, my darlings,
If I zoom in, keep focused on the middle of the screen, there's a classic Mickey right there in the middle. Do you see? Very well hidden. But it's a hidden Mickey! Who hasn't found it? Who needs help? Liv needs help. Have you found it? Can you see it? It's there. Where?
As you
there.
Said, there. Time,
yeah, it's there, yeah. Well done, we did it. Okay, from there, which one's next? Which you've got? Oh, it says to go to the lounge. Lounge. What's the clue?
When exploring is your aim, you'll find Mickey has staked his claim. You only need to find the pot. When you've done that, you've found the spot.
Interesting. Oh, so we're heading around this way to go find a lounge. You see, there's boats on Seven Seas Lagoon there. There you go, it says boat transportation. Guys, a point is that way where we've just come from.
Yeah,
oh, you went to the cafe, didn't you?
Yeah, it's a grill and bar, so you can have light food in there.
It looks like a nice place to get some grub, doesn't it? Oh, not a widgety grub. You looked at the menu.
This one says so. Number 6, each floor. Walk the hallways and explore, you'll find me on every floor.
Oh, so we've got to. Well, we need to find the lounge, so just go back towards the lobby and find a lounge. Yeah, lovely. Walkways here. Oh, and it's like all wet. It's like swampy. Oh, yeah. I thought it was just going to be like, I don't know, fake grass or something, but it's like we're properly in the wilderness. It's very immersive here. Oh, they do bike rentals as well. Yes. Okay. Come around this way. Let's find the next clue, shall we? Follow the Famalam. Look at the epic architecture. I do love it here. Very nice. I know I've never stayed here, but just think about the design of it. I mean, you don't get this with a lot of other hotels, do you? This is the Disney immersive magic. I'm living the dream, darlings. Living the dream. Well, I've got Wussey Grub to come outside because there's two clues at the lounge. I was vlogging earlier and I randomly picked number 7, Territory Lounge, is there.
Also, it's just up that hall.
So I think we need to go to 7. What's the restaurant called in there? Oh, it's called the Roaring Fork, which is 9.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, so we're here.
Literally up there.
We went into that corner, we need to walk up the corridor, and it's there. I think that's the lounge. There's two clues at the lounge, so let's head that way. I guess it's easier if you've been here for a few days, then you actually know where these places are.
Follow me,
guys. We are novices. We're following you, darling. Okay, so we've come up this ramp. We found a sign that says Territory Lounge.
But it's only open 4 till 10 p.m.
So it can't be in there. Is it maybe outside? This is tricky. I thought it was going to be there. Can you see a pot or anything anywhere? Oh, we're here. That's the bridge that we went over earlier, me and Amelia. We thought it'd be here at the lounge, so we're going to have to keep looking.
If your glass of brew, have a cup of stew. Read the map in the sky, you'll find me if you try.
I wonder if this is the map in the sky, so this could be the clue after the clue that we're on. But that's a map. In the sky, so could it be on here? I found it first, but I just found it. The one about the pot. It is on this map. I'm zooming in on the middle of the screen. Keep looking in that pot. Sorry about the reflection, Thomas. There. Can you see the hidden Mickey inside that pot? Yes, that's it. Very tiny hidden Mickey in the pot on this very giant map. Oh, yeah, it's a map of the lounge.
Excuse me.
Get in there. Which one was that one?
I'm confused.
Yeah.
You said you only find the pot. When you've done that, you found the spot.
Yeah,
so
we did.
So that is the pot. But then read the map in the sky. You'll find me if you try.
So maybe there's another one.
So that means there's actually two.
Read the map in the sky. You'll find me if you try. Yes, come up here. I was wrong. I thought there wouldn't be a clue in here because it's closed. But I didn't realise it's closed as in they're not serving anything. But it is open. Yeah, you can walk in. Oh, no.
Oh, it's huge.
So now there's this giant map on the sky. I like these bears. Yes, get neck ache. This is cool. Have you? Where?
No?
Oh, I don't know.
Are these your perfect?
Got to look on here. Wow. I don't know. Sometimes you crush yourself.
That's perfect. That's just an odd shape. That one in the corner down the room.
Oh, I'm not sure. No. Keep looking. Florence, I found it.
I found it.
Where? Right. Look up. Keep going up, and then you see there's a man, and he's pulling horses.
Oh, yeah.
And then if I look on the horse's bottom, I think that horse has got a hidden Mickey on his bottom.
What a random place to put a Mickey on your bottom. Did you find it? Can you see it?
Yeah.
Yeah, did it hurt your neck looking? Yeah.
You did it.
Okay, number 6 is on each floor and it says, walk the hallways and explore, you'll find me on every floor. Look beneath your feet, finding me will be a treat. I'm gonna guess it's like the carpet in the hallways when you're going to your room. So I feel like we need to pretend to be guests and you know, look on the carpets. But also, the next one, number 7, is at the restaurant, and we've just come for a wee-wee again. Yes, I know. And at the restaurant, in this canyon, there is a rule, whispering isn't cool. Hidden Mickey can be seen nestled in the fireplace screen. So I think we need to go in the restaurant or look around the restaurant and find a fireplace. And then also we need to remember we need to go back to number 6. Well, I'm in the restaurant, looking very weird because I'm not actually getting anything, any food. I'm trying to find a fireplace wall.
It's a conga line.
And it's not going very well. So I'm going to head back out and see if it's outside the restaurant. Right, and yeah, I can't find any fireplace screen, but the fireplace is down there. So does it actually mean on the fireplace screen? Because we started here at this fireplace. Which do Grub is calling me over?
This might be like way off the mark, but this is the restaurant. This is the fireplace screen.
Yeah, no, I was just saying that. Maybe it is that we're back here. So it makes sense. And I've just been in the restaurant and there was not a fireplace screen in there. This is definitely a fireplace screen. So let's look on here. Hold your horses. He's run off. Oh, yes, look. The back of the fireplace. Ah, and we were just saying we felt like we weren't in the restaurant because the first place, oh yes, the first clue said that we're in the lobby and we were like, well, it can't be the same place. And yeah, look, that's the restaurant I was in. Again, because we don't stay here, we don't know. There's an extra bit here and there's another fireplace wall. It's here.
I've seen it.
Have you?
Oh.
Okay, I'm going to try and find it. Well, we're a bit unsure on this one. We weren't sure if this was a hidden Mickey in the middle there, but we're not necessarily convinced. And then we've seen down in this white bit, there's some like shapes in here that kind of give Mickey shapes, but we're not sure, are we, Florence? We're not sure. But here we are, we're just on our knees on the floor under the fireplace, looking very confused. There's another fireplace. Take me. Take my hand. There's another fireplace. Oh gosh, another fireplace. This is really hard. So again, we're still in the back of the restaurant. Who knew there was so many fireplaces? Where?
Underneath there.
I'm gonna beat your head.
Underneath. Can you see it?
No.
Right, no, like underneath. Very, very.
Oh, like underneath.
Right underneath.
Let's go here.
Can you zoom in there? It's the 1, 2, 3rd one along. Point at it, Florin. There!
Oh my gosh, there! That is a hidden Mickey.
That is very hidden.
That is so hidden.
And also, look where we're sitting. Look where we
Does
are.
Does it say something?
No.
B.
B. I. Mickey.
It says something.
Yeah.
Is that an F? B. M.
My knees are hurting, so I've got to get up.
What is this? Are these letters? There's something written all along there, hidden. But yes, there is the hidden Mickey. That is really hard. I don't think I'd have even looked down there. I'd have just been inspecting the general fireplace. Okay, there's only one more to go. But well done.
Also,
you did it. Yeah.
We have to literally go on our hands and knees. So like, what if somebody sat there?
Oh, true. Oh well. But we did it! Yay! Come on, Florence, let's go! Come on, Amelia. We've got one more to find. We need to work out how to go up. So maybe if we take the lift and we go up one level. Okay, we're out the lift. I was just looking at the menu there, but I haven't got time. We've got to come out. We're going to look on the carpet, I reckon, because it said about being on the floor. You are really being a good detective. Where?
It's like that. It's not finished, but it's like that.
Let's that keep looking.
Well, this is
every floor.
I'm just going to fall into the floor.
Okay, keep looking, keep looking. I can see it.
Have you?
Yes, I found it.
Where?
Keep having a keep looking.
I found it.
Where? Yeah! That one is an easier one. There's
Where?
A Mickey in cream.
Where?
See? Here and here.
Yay.
The Mickeys! Oh. And that's why they must be on every floor.
Yeah,
yes? Where?
Here.
Oh yeah, in the corners. On every floor. There you go. Wow, oh wow, look at the view! We're on level 5. People down below, they look like little ants. Wow, we're not even on the top. Oh, it's epic. That's the side of the totem. We did it, Witchy Grub.
We did it.
So now, once you've completed, I hope you've filled in your form, you've got to take it back to the desk and see if we get a prize. Olivia, wave.
She's on FaceTime.
Look. We've got her on PCA. We've got her on FaceTime.
And she's there.
And she's all the way down there as well.
Yay.
Quick, get in the lift. Get in the lift. I'm coming, coming, coming. Oh yeah, look. Whispering Canyon Cafe. Oh, Mickey.
Brunch. Oh my god.
Oh, brunch barbecue, like BBQ, barbecue.
Mm, that sounds good.
Or you can count.
We've only got 10 minutes left of that.
And then there's dinner there.
Oh, this one looks good.
Oh yeah.
Burger.
Roaring Fork.
Yeah, wait.
Things there. Wait. Guys up on wait. Bar and Grill. Get
them.
No, Tower of Terror. Come on.
Give it to
Florence, come on. Take your sheet. Hand it in and say I did the hidden Mickey hunt. And let's get a prize. Lift her up. She can't see.
There we go.
Yeah. You did it. Let's see. See what prize we get. Something might be coming.
I'll give you this.
Oh, you got a little thing. Wow, you got prizes. Ooh. You got prizes, Florence. Wow. The suspense.
You like any okay. Prizes?
Who's your favourite character?
Your favourite character?
Or your favourite play?
What about Mickey? Because we're doing hidden Mickey hunt.
Mickey or Minnie or
Mickey. Mickey's coming. Well, whilst we're waiting, I can see another Mickey on here. I don't think this is a hidden Mickey, but there's a Mickey right there in the middle as well. Yeah.
And a little.
Ooh. So we've got this little pin.
Little pin.
And when you turn it over, it says, welcome home.
Oh my goodness.
Oh,
wow. You got a pin.
You got a pin.
Oh, a Mickey special. Pin.
Is that good? A special Mickey pin.
Happy?
Yeah.
Whoa.
Amazing. Thank you very much. Yeah, well done, Florence. You did it. There we go. That's the Mickey pin. Very smart. He looks very smart, doesn't he? Oh, this is the life. Living the dream after the hidden Mickey hunt. We're just on this little secret section out here,
lovely.
Having a rest. Oh, look. Hello, Florence. Hello. Yes, stay away, please. Stay the other side of the fence. You have to pay to come and view, see us, like meet and greet.
$50 an hour, please, sir.
$50 to come and see us.
Bye.
Goodbye, goodbye. We're gonna head down this way. Which is of course the way we went to Geyser Point. We can go to that was it the Bar and Grill? The Geyser Point Bar and Grill, whatever it was called. We're gonna go down there for some luncheon, darlings. Help me, I'm stuck. Oh, I can go back in these doors. I forgot, silly me. Right, we've made it to Geyser Point Bar and Grill. Well, here you go. If you want table service, go to the left. From 11 a.m. to 11 p.m, so it's really late at night. We can get the to-go orders. HOTTOGO. You can get guys a point hot to go. Oh, hello there. Yes, table service, please. Yes, thank you. Wowzers! This definitely gets a Wussey wowzers for me. Oh look, there's games here. Pool table, table football, table tennis. We come out here, this is Seven Seas Lagoon. It's absolutely
massive. And yes, this is a real lagoon. This is not theme park lagoon. This is a proper lagoon. You can hire boats, and there's that free Disney transportation that will take you to the parks. That's looking over towards them. That's Bay Lake Tower. Next to it, which you can't quite see behind those trees, is the Contemporary Resort. All this nice seating out here. Isn't it nice, Wichita Grub?
Oh, it's gorgeous.
It's gorgeous. It's very, very nice. What do you think, girls? Is it nice?
Yeah, get used to this.
Get used to this, yes. I think we'll move in. Are there alligators in there? Yes, absolutely a yes. So they've got our number. Well, they've got mummy's number, and we're just waiting for them to send us a message to say our table is ready. So I'm like, are we going to be here? Are we going to be low down? Are we going to be on one of the higher tables? I don't know, darlings. Everyone else is just out there, looking out at Seven Seas Lagoon. Another view for you there. And that goes over to Geyser Point. Oh, I can't wait for my food. I was totally right. This is our table. Yay! Let's check out the menu, darlings. We've got what I presume these are the starters. Cheese and charcuterie, shrimp on a wire, crab cakes, mac and cheese bites, which the cub just saw them and said they looked amazing.
Excuse
chicken wings,
me.
Yes?
I've just seen somebody with the mac and cheese bites there and they look amazing.
And I didn't just say that on the vlog.
You did say that, yeah.
I did just say that, yeah. See? Yes, he just saw this. We've got the flatbread. Peking ribs. I love things like that. Non-alcoholic speciality libations? I was going to say liberations, but that just says libations. That's just like a lava smoothie, strawberry smoothie. Then we've got the rustic fare from 11 till 10 p.m. Oh, these are your mains then. Cheeseburger, turkey BLT sandwich, vegetable burger with cheese, steak sandwich, multigrain salad with chicken, fried chicken sandwich, add edamame with chili salt. I love that. And then the kids meals for ages 9 and under. You've got cheeseburger, or kids meals served with small low-fat milk or a small Dasani bottled water, right. Turkey bento box, cheese flatbread, chicken strips. Desserts, yes please. Campfire mousse, seasonal pie, so we'll have to find out what the pie is. Apple cider sorbet with berries and a fruit plate. And I've just seen the background, the image in the background, is the geyser shooting the water up for Geyser Point. And then we've got the signature libations as well. So this is your, I presume, your alcoholic drinks. Lots of lovely alcoholic drinks there, my darling. Pina colada, yes. Draft beer and cider. Funky butter Floridian wheat. Don't know that one. Beer, hard cider and hard seltzer. And then what's the final thing? We've got wine, don't you worry, darling. Sparkling rosé, white wines, red wines. Look, see if you can get them per the glass or by the bottle. So now I've got to decide what I'm going to get. Oh, we got given cups of ice water for free.
Can I get a soda with that,
please? We're just making our food order, but the strawberry smoothie has arrived. How is it, Richard DeGrub?
So good.
What's it taste like?
This is the lava smoothie.
Oh, it's the lava smoothie. Oh, the lava smoothie. I apologise. Lava smoothie is the raspberry puree blended with flavours of coconut and pineapple.
It's so good.
Oh, yeah, let's have a look. Show it to me. Oh, show me a bit, show me a bit. Oh, there it is. Yummy. Our mac and cheese bites have arrived and look how they come. Lift them off.
Oh,
you've got, oh, is it? They've got two little plates, Mickey. To show it. Yay! We've got the kids' chicken wings here with grapes and fries. And then what are these?
Chicken teriyaki wings.
Chicken teriyaki wings. So that's a starter. Lovely. Right, so I'm going to cut into my mac and cheese ball. Ooh.
Ooh, that looks really good.
Lots of mac and cheese in there. Delicious. And then look at my amazing turkey sandwich. That's very thick. Well, it's got Gouda cheese in, if I'm saying correctly. Turkey in there. Wow, yeah. There's loads.
Sorry.
Loads in there with my fries. And Wichita Grub, he's got his chicken. Oh, look how big that piece of chicken is.
Massive.
Of course,
some fries with him.
It's huge.
And some fries.
Wowzers.
Oh, yeah.
Wow. Look at the cross section of my turkey sandwich. That's epic. I love it. Very good. And these chips are perfect fries. Very, very good tasting fries. Lovely. I'm running. I've left my food. Yes, I've got it. Geyser. The geyser's going off at Geyser Point. It does say it goes off every hour. Let's see if I can get all the way to the edge, my darlings. Wow, there you go. What time is it? Oh, it's like just gone 10 to 3. I thought it might go off like on the hour every hour. But that's the geyser going off. So if we'd have stayed here, we'd have known not to look for a hidden Mickey down here. And we'd have gone all the way around there and known that that's the geyser point. So a bit further round. Wow. Oh, it's so good to see it. And now I'm going to go back to where I came from. I'm back to getting the food. I've made a mistake. I don't have my second battery fully charged for my vlogging camera, so I'm now using my iPhone for the rest of the day. So I hope the audio and I hope everything is of good quality. But yes, going back to join the family here. But yeah, I had to just run over and get that shot. It's gone off now. I'm out of breath and I have half a turkey sandwich stuck in my throat. Ah! Time for the second half of my sandwich. This feels like one of those challenges when they give you so much food and you win a prize if you can finish it. This is a lot of sandwich. Well, we've finished having our food. That's a last look at the last tour of the pools, my darlings. We're going to head this way, follow Wussey Grub, because we're going to try and get a boat to...
Magic Kingdom, baby.
The Magic Kingdom! That's what we're going to see if we can do. I thought we were just going to go around just the hotels today.
Oh, I think we just missed the boat.
You see the boats? That's where we're heading. Woo, hope it works. Well, that was amazing.
Woo.
John is back here, works for Disney, taking those
from memory. Denver, Colorado.
Oh, was he? Yeah, he's doing like the memory maker photos. He said, how do you know each other? I said, we are fiancés. He looked at the rings. Oh, which
and
way
I said,
are we going?
This way. And I said, as of last week.
And he did like a special like photo session.
Indeed.
So if the photos are any good and if I can be bothered to edit them in, then you might be looking at them right now. But we put hands together and he did photos of the rings with a bit of wilderness in the background. And then he checked with the family behind us if it was okay if we took a bit of extra time with us. And he took us to these trees and then we did a pose like poking through the trees or something like that.
It was like fiancés in the wilderness, I think.
Fiancés in the wilderness. That's what we did. So
he was really sweet.
Oh gosh, and now the kiddies are running towards us because
the boat's here!
The boat is coming.
Guess what?
What?
I saw a mermaid.
A real mermaid?
Yeah.
Was it Ariel?
I think so.
Woo.
Like a shadow go under the water. And it was like the shape of like a mermaid.
Cool.
Also known as an alligator.
The boat is coming in. Florence said, which boat are we going on? So we want to go follow the red flag to Disney's Magic Kingdom. Operates half hour prior to park opening until half an hour after the park closes. And then, oh, there's one here on this side. Oh yeah, look, it's blue. It's got a blue rim. Does that mean it's the blue rim because it's a blue one? That's the blue flag for Disney's Fort Wilderness Resort and Campground. So that's the bit that I said, no offense, is going to be more like Center Parks, like cabins in the woods type thing, and Disney's Contemporary Resort. So you go to the blue side if you want to go to resorts. I think the campgrounds is like all this area over here. You can't really see very well, as in it's all hidden behind trees. And then River Country, we think, was like behind, it was here. We used to go River Country all the time. And we were trying to remember where it was. So we looked on Google Maps and we think it's kind of like that area that it used to be. River Country was a water park right on the edge. And used to come to the wilderness section to get there. But, I'm wrong about the blue trim. So the blue trim doesn't link because otherwise this will be red. So follow the red, oh, maybe there's a red flag. There's a red flag on the front. Ah, yes. And there's a blue flag on the front there. So that's what you're looking for. So ignore the blue trim and follow the red flag for a boat for a scenic trip around the Magic Kingdom. Tell me what you just heard.
Do you think that gator's gonna eat the other gator like that?
Yeah, a man was just getting off the boat and he said, do you think that gator was going to eat the other gator? So
Ooh. And that's the boat that we're getting on now.
Where is the
boat? Oh, we're moving along. So we're going to look out for gators that are eating other gators.
I can't
wait.
As we get on the boat. Yeah.
Wow, this boat. There you go. That's the red flag at the front. It's very small. It feels like your own, like, private... Very like a private boat to the Magic Kingdom. Deluxe, darlings. Lovely, darlings. Thank you very much. Here we go. Very nice. Oh, it's in the shade as well. Where shall we sit? Hello! We're on the move, and I spy the little villas or bungalows. I don't know what they're called officially. Sorry, my darling.
No, I think they are villas.
Well, they're a bit of both, aren't they? They're villas and bungalows. They're all along the side from Wilderness. Oh, you see it in the distance? Monorail! We're going right by the Contemporary Resort. The monorail goes through there, through the tunnels. That's the track.
So, goodbye to the Wilderness Lodge area.
And hello to the Contemporary Resort area. Still a long way to go. And I can see the entrance to Magic Kingdom. Yay! So you got Contemporaries behind us. Magic Kingdom's there. The Grand Floridian is there, and the Polynesian is just going behind that island there. So these are all part of the Magic Kingdom Resort hotels, and of course that does include the Wilderness Lodge where we just came from. I can see Cinderella Castle! Woohoo! Well, that is very good service. We've come out of the boat there. All we've got to do is walk along this way, and we're at the entrance there. Very good.
I love days like this. One day you just wake up, you chill by the pool, and you think, why don't we go check out some hotels? And then the next second, you're at the Magic Kingdom. Oh my God. Woo. It's 3:56, so almost 4 p.m. And now that we've come into the park, I just thought I'd check online to see if I can get a virtual queue for either for Tiana's Bayou Adventure, which I obviously thought was going to be very unlikely, or Tron. And I can confirm we've got Tron. We've never been on Tron. Never been on Tron. Isn't it a magical day? We're going on Tron today. This afternoon we're going on Tron. I'm so excited. I can't wait to tell everyone.
Well, hello there, Main Street Transportation Company trolley bus ride thing. Hello. What theme park gives you such a resonance as that? I love it. Oh, I can hear the Dapper Dance.
Yes, yeah.
I can hear the singers. Let's see if we can go get them. All of the skeleton, pumpkin-y scarecrows, that's it, scarecrows, they're out. Oh yay, I can hear things. Let's go see what's happening. Richard, we're in the Magic Kingdom, baby. Oh, I can't read. They're singing Great Big Beautiful Tomorrow from the Carousel of Progress. I used to want to be one of these, and then I saw the dancer in front of the castle and realised how I want to be a dancer in front of the castle. Oh, the harmony is really, really good. And what are these funny instruments they have? Yes, good cat coordination.
Oh, they just finished. Isn't it good? Which did you grow?
Yeah, I love it.
It's so good. Would you like my fiance? Would you like...
That's me.
Or would you like a balloon?
No, I would not, but I'm sure the little kitties would love a balloon.
I know, but if you had a balloon, how would you take it on Tron? I don't know.
I do want a drinky though.
I know, I'm really thirsty now coming here, but there she is, my house, Cinderella Castle. Where did you grow up? Are you nervous? The last time
not
we were
today.
In front of it, I got down on one knee and I proposed. What if I propose again?
No.
Would you say yes?
I'd say no, because I'd be like,
you're already doing it, silly.
Oh, okay. I won't do it again then.
Oh, will I?
We've come into Main Street Confectionery. Look at the colour kitchen. Wow, are they M&M's, what are they?
Yes.
M&M's, create with colour and please your palette. Yeah?
I found it.
Oh my gosh, I used to always have that, the marshmallow.
We've got Mickey Mallow beating Skittles.
Oh, with Skittles? Yeah. I really want it. Oh, I love the confectionery shops, but also it's... I've got such a sneak... tooth is Lowe's. I have such a sweet tooth that I end up getting far too much. Oopsie. Ooh, it's caramel popcorn.
Lots of M&Ms there as well. Sensing a theme with the M&Ms.
This is where I would work.
Oh, I'd love to work here. Wow, look. The Colonel Kitchen. Look how amazing all these snacks and treats are. Wow. Oh, yeah, look. Main Street Confectionery. The Sweetest Spoon Showcase. I love all their outfits as well. They're full on, like, dressed to the part. There's a kitchen over that way. Another kitchen over. Oh, I see it says cupcakes. Who's the sweetest of them all?
Me.
Oh, look. Big, big lollies. This is why. Oh, the big ones are here. You know, I showed you before at Wilderness Lodge, they've got the case to put the big lollies in. So, yes, if you get a big lolly, you're not going to finish all that in one go. So you need the full case. Cotton candy all behind there. They do astounding apples to appease any appetite. Well, this is clever. It shows you all of the different, like, famous, like, chocolate bars and things to do. So M&Ms, it describes the M&Ms. It describes Snickers. Twix, of course, we know a Twix. Skittles, these are all things that are owned by the Mars company. Milky Way, I love a Milky Way. Three Musketeers, I think Three Musketeers is a Milky Way just in America. I haven't read this all properly, so you find out, but I'm sure it tells me on there. Oh yes, look, like Lead to the Sweets. And it tells you, hailing from hometowns across the country, get to know the champion chefs wielding the nation's sweetest spoons. Are these the people that invented it all? I'm not sure. You'll have to pause it and read that if you want to read it. Oh, they do shortbread pieces as well. Mickey-shaped shortbreads. It's all going on here at Main Street Confectionery. I've got to give you a close-up of the treats in here. Wow, you say. Wow, caramel apple. Mickey caramel apple. What's it? Oh, it looks like, I thought it was like a tub of salad, but that's the popcorn pick and mix options. They're like pre-prepared for you. Oh my goodness me. And there's no calories in any of this. What is this? A blondie pie? Brownie pie with peanut M&Ms. Oh my goodness me. Very good. Hello, Richard Digwam.
Hello.
Yes.
But they've got the nice snacks in.
Oh, this is what I've been looking for.
Yeah, I've been looking for them everywhere. I can't find them. And now
Rich Dugo got me a tub of these a few years ago,
five years ago.
I never tried them. They're like, are they like traditional Disney Halloween candies?
Candy corn.
Candy corn, they're called.
Oh, look.
And now I can get some.
You think that's a book? It's not. It's a big chocolate bar.
A big chocolate bar, hocus pocus style. Yee! Wowzers. These are before they get covered up. To make the how they make the Mickey show. Hello, hello, they're all waving. And then over here, look, candied popcorn. I think this is where you get your, like, you know when you go pick and mix? Just getting big scoops of popcorn up from there. You can get, oh yeah, look, pick your popcorn, select a syrup, and then combine it with candies. So that's up here. And oh, you can get like a Halloween trick mix. Oh my gosh, look at that menu there. There's so many options and loads of toppings here. Oh, it's very good. And then you come back out this way and you're back at the entrance. And we're going to go and find wherever the family have gone to. Yes. Oh, I can see Marn and Pa down there. But I have lost a witch to grow up. I'll have to go find him.
Oh, this really has been the best day ever!
Discovering new dreams.
That's an adventure for sure.
Trying something new.
And having a swinging good time.
You win.
Finding the confidence to be true to yourself.
That's right.
Here's to all of us, all friends and new.
More hugs for everyone.
audition?
Oh yes, I know all the moves.
Okay, just go on the stage now and audition. Yes, you got the job. You just need to go to the casting offices. Just walk in and demand an audition. Yes. Where did you grow up? Amelia. I have a question, Katie.
Oh, it's very, very hot.
What day is it today? But what day is it if you head into Tomorrowland?
Sunday.
But if it's Sunday, then we're not here anymore. Because it's Saturday. It's a puzzle. What day are we in?
It's too hot.
Are we still in Saturday or Sunday? Oh, I'm confused. Well, I for one thought the wait would be longer because we don't have a landing lane, but it's 30 minutes. So seeing as it's a Saturday, you know, weekend, that's not too bad. Tron is down that way, and of course the family don't know. I've got us into virtual queue for that. But yes, Space Mountain, 30 minutes. Come on, HD Club, Space Mountain.
I like this queue because on very hot and humid days like this, it's nice in the dark, it's very air conditioned, very refreshing. So if you want to get out of the sun and cool down, go on Space Mountain like me. We're on the right. Hello, Wichita Club. Woo! Oh my goodness me! Wow! On? You went on Tomorrowland Speedway? Yeah?
The car ride.
Yes, that's this one. You went on the car ride here. And then what's above it? Did you go on the people mover? Up there! So you went on the people mover up there and the Tomorrowland Speedway down here. Was it good? Richard Igwob and Amelia are on the car ride. So we're going to sit on the chairs here and we're going to wave at them. Yeah, you've just been on there. Let's watch for them, shall we? Look out for your sister. Yeah! Hello! Come on, Amelia. Come on, Wichita Club. They're driving. Are you waving, Florence? Did you see them? Yeah! Off they go. They're speeding fast. Look how fast they're going on the Tomorrowland Speedway. Woo! Oh, a bit of congestion in lane two. Woo! Come on, everyone! Come on, Richard, come on, Amelia! Yay! I didn't know Amelia could drive. She told me this morning that she didn't have a license. What was that? What was that front? Well, either way, they don't have a license.
Come on!
I got no plastic because it's slow.
I checked the weather app and I can confirm that in about 10 to 12 minutes there is a lightning thunderstorm on its way. So normally when an outdoor ride closes I get suspicious thinking, hang on a minute, why would you close it? Has it broken down or have you closed it on purpose? And yes, obviously outdoor rides don't really tend to operate unless they're properly covered, especially when lightning's coming. So apart from a few dark clouds, I wouldn't actually really know. So we're heading to Fantasyland because I'm thinking if a storm is coming, we want to be where there's indoor rides and where we can maybe jump about, going like from like indoor rides, like we've got Under the Sea, we could go to Winnie the Pooh, Peter Pan's Flight, we could do It's a Small World again, or pop over to Haunted Mansion or something. There's basically lots of like more like indoor things that hopefully will still be operating even though there's a lightning storm. And if we have to go out in the rain, it's just a case of like running between those rides. That's what I was thinking anyway. Whether that's the right thing to do or not, I don't know. But yes, at the minute, no rain, but I'm guessing that in the next, 10 minutes, we will be in a lightning thunderstorm. Woo!
Whoa! Oh no, look! They all fell out. Oopsie! Well, my friend King Triton has invited me to a ball. Only this time it's under the sea. Oh, it says no. Oh, it does say 30 minutes. It's very faint, I couldn't see it very well. So we're going to go. Oh, there's who she is. You can just see her.
Under the sea.
Under the sea.
Under the coke.
There is a hidden Mickey in here. I'll try and show you if I can find it. I have to remind myself where it is. I have seen it before. But isn't this really good theming? If you see a little mermaid animation, I think you can agree. We've stepped into the movie. Oh, I just felt rain on my arm. I just felt rain on my arm, which did grow. I think the storm may be coming. Come on, rain. Come on, so you can get it over with. Be gone by the time we're out. Well, I have looked and I can't find the hidden Mickey here. So I will keep searching, I promise. I'm sure it was here, but I don't know where it is. Sorry, folks. I'll keep looking. Our clamshells are ready. It's time to get on. Come on, witch Nigwab. Let's go see Ariel.
Ooh, Ariel.
Hello, family.
Hello.
Hello. We've just had a momentary pause on the ride. We are literally at the start with Scuttle. Look at our shoes, they've
gone on.
Hello, Ariel, my darling. Good to see you. Yes. Hello. Shantae. Stay. Ah, Ursula, sashay away. Right, so we've come outside and it's actually lovely and sunny. So I don't really know what's happened to the rain that was supposed to be coming, because there's no lightning at all. It's a lie. So I think somewhere here is supposed to be a Mickey. This is a hidden Mickey here. If I work it out, I'll let you know, but they're supposed to like Mickey's hat. Oh, is this an ear? And this is like Mickey's butt somewhere? Let me know if you can see it. Let me know in the comments. Somewhere here, especially, and this is supposed to like Mickey's hat. Oh, I see it. Okay, I've got it. Right. Imagine that Mickey is, you know, Steamboat Willie, Mickey. This is Mickey, but he's facing that way. That is his nose and that's his eye. Oh, sorry about the focus. This is his hat. These are his shorts with the two little, like, you know, he has the two little like buttons. This here is his foot. This is the steering wheel of the boat and that there is his hand. Can you see Mickey? He's on Steamboat Willie and it's all hidden in the rocks there. I can totally see it now. I'm going to take a photo as well. I just took the photo. Yeah, that is the hidden Mickey. So it's on the way out, not on the way in. And so I was mistaken. That's why I couldn't find it. It was somewhere in the rocks. I couldn't find it. Right, let's go find the family and we can rejoice because we haven't got to run around in the rain. I thought we would. Are we doing a photo? Oh, I reckon she's going to do her cartwheel. Come on, Amelia. Go, Amelia, cartwheel time in front of Ariel. Oh, that was a really good one. Well done, Simone Biles. Really good. I'm following Wichley Grub to Gaston's Tavern. There's Gaston in Le Fou. There's something, we had like a sweet treat thing in here a few years ago. I've forgotten what it is. I just remember putting lots of icing on it. Oh my gosh, I can see it. Here it is. Oh, it doesn't say what it's called.
Oh, that sounds
good. It just says pastry.
Frozen Minute Maid apple juice. Oh, I don't like apple. With hint of toasted marshmallows, topples.
I love apple juice. What are you talking about? This. And you can ask for like extra icing to put on top, but I can't remember what it's called. Let's go in. I have a feeling because he uses antlers in all of his decorating. Yes, there's antlers everywhere because, like I said, he does sing a song about using antlers in all of his decorating. What is it called? Oh, there you go. It's a warm, zoom in. Oh, that's a quick zoom on the phone, sorry. It's a warm cinnamon roll.
But they also do the creme brulee croissant.
The grey stuff, cupcake. Creme brulee croissant. Ham and brulee tart. Don't know what brulee is. Brulee.
What do you want for supper?
I'd like the warm cinnamon roll.
Do I get the creme brulee croissant as well? I'm intrigued by it.
Get whatever you want. Hashtag gifted.
So we got the I got the cinnamon swirl thing with icing, and then Richard was like, "Oh, should we just share that?" And I was like, "Oh." So then he said, "Fine." So he got the the creme brulee croissant.
Yeah.
So I was like, "Yay, we get two snacks!" And then she also got us the grey stuff, and she said, "Because you two are adorable, have this."
So we've basically now got we've got
three treats here.
But I will eat.
Even though Richard wanted to just share the one. But we were adorable, so we got the grey stuff. Oh. I can't believe it. Is it good?
It's hard, but it's good.
Start with the cinnamon swirly roll thing.
Mmm, it's warm.
Oh, is it? Oh, yeah, that's like just come out of the oven.
Oh my God, it's so good.
Oh, it's really soft.
Mmm.
Mm. Oh, it's very nice.
And what's this, creme brulee croissant?
Creme brulee croissant? Show me the cross section, please.
Mmm.
What's in it?
Vanilla.
Oh, like a cream?
Mmm.
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 Very nice.
And I can't bite into the cupcake.
No. But that's the grey stuff cupcake. Oh, yeah. Let me have some. Oh, yeah.
Mmm.
Oh, that's great. It's cold.
It's thick as well.
Cold and thick. Just how you like it. Hello, princess. What have you got?
Mickey's ice cream sandwich.
I love the sandwich. And what have you got, Florence? You got the Magnum, Mickey's premium bar. You and me. Look at the snacks we've got.
Oh,
woo!
They look good.
We were just going to get the one,
yep.
And then Witcher Gov said to get this one, and then she said we were adorable, so for free, she gave us the grey stuff.
You're adorable.
Yes, well, I think it was directed at me. We might be doing something that we've never done before. The new Country Bear Jamboree. Oh, was it Musical Jamboree? The new Country Bear Musical Jamboree. They've revamped it, they've changed things. I've avoided it online, so I don't know what the changes are, but I think we're going to go in and do something that I've never done. Well, I did it the old version, but I've never done the new version. There's continuous shows from 9 a.m. till 11 p.m. and we're going straight in, no wait. This kind of looks the same. There's all the bears.
News from the front line.
Yes.
Florence doesn't like this version, she likes the old one.
She hasn't seen this version,
and I said, you've not seen it? She went, I don't like the new one.
Well, she watched it online?
I don't know.
Oh, well, we'll see. She doesn't know what she's talking about. Let's go in. Oh, I wonder if they've revamped the theatre. Oh, yes, it looks shiny and new.
Oh, it looks fresh.
Oh, it does look fresh. Sorry, my film's not very good. There you go. Grizzly
Hall,
established
1892. I can't wait to see it again. Every afternoon, the sounds will be stuck in my head. Where else will they get stuck? We don't have bodies.
I love that they talk. Yay! Oh yeah, so these sit on the side and they talk and join in animatronics, and then the show is going to be all along here.
Looks like the game's just
about
ready, so now's the time to remind you.
Very nice.
We've already got breakfast.
Already I can see an improvement. Look how full it is. It's absolutely wrapped. This is the finale. We're doing the bare necessities. It's so cool, everyone. It's absolutely, look at it. We did it! Woo!
It was so much fun!
It was so good! Did you like it, girls?
Yes.
Yeah, and have you seen it before online?
No.
No? You haven't seen it?
I don't know.
You can't remember? What was your favourite bit?
My favourite bit was... I like the girl group.
The girl group.
Is that when they were singing, try everything?
That was the best bit. What was your favourite bit? That bit as well?
No, what was your favourite bit?
Remember
when Big Bear sang Remember Me.
Yeah.
And then he was like, it's too sad to go on. So he cried and he stopped singing. Okay. Oh, it was really funny.
It was very good.
It was good because it combines the nostalgic old school Country Bear Jamboree feel. They haven't got rid of that. but they've just brought in some, I guess, more updated, more recent Disney songs. And also it opened with like a new original song. Yeah. So yeah. I'm going to be getting the album and I'm going to be listening to it all the time.
It was good.
It was really good. Yeah. Oh. Yo ho, yo ho, a pirate's life for me.
We are heading into Adventureland. And more importantly, we're going to head over there and go on the Pirates of the Caribbean. Woo! I don't think it has too long of a wait. I did notice the shop, as you come out, which is here, these are people who have been on the ride, the shop is down for refurbishment, so please pardon the pixie dust. Or they've said, not all treasures, silver and, I'm trying to read it, silver and gold, mate. Oh, I don't understand it. That's what the sign said. But yes, we're going in here. It says the standby wait is 15 minutes. That's not long at all. We're getting in our boat. We're getting in our boat. In we get. Get in, everyone. What? What do you mean, what?
I got the dry seat.
I got the dry seat, but Nanny got
the wet seat. In they come. Come on. Time to go to the Caribbean. I can confirm that this is actually my favourite bit. It's very cool, it's very atmospheric. I know you can't see me much, but I like the waterfalls, I like the dark caves. It's very mysterious, darlings. Where are we going? Ooh, a scary skeleton face. And then, look, what has happened to this man? He's been left here, he's starved, he's turned to a skeleton. Oh dear, I think he's got crabs.
What may I offer for these hearty hens? Everyone an egg layer.
Not less than the
eggs. Without a look at this here map and this lovely key to a treasure.
There they are, singing along. Oh, lemonade. Hashtag iconic. Yes, darlings. Yes. Good work, darlings. See you on the t-shirt. See you on the merch. And there he is, Johnny Depp. Oh, I mean, Jack Sparrow. Captain Jack Sparrow, to be correct.
With his parrot. Hey.
What did the cast member just sing as we were getting out? She said, yeah. Yo ho, yo ho, it's time to get off the boat. It's funny.
Family?
Yes?
What would you say if I told you I've managed to get us onto Tron?
Yes!
Ah, and it's time to head to Tron now!
Yes!
Woo! Let's go! Look how pretty Crystal Palace is looking. And coming round to Casey's Corner.
I love the chips in Casey's Corner. I remember the chips so well.
We're basically making our way over to Tomorrowland that way, going past the castle. Hello, Cinderella Castle, looking gorgeous. We'll look at the crowds in the middle. What time is it? Let me look at the time. It's nearly 25 past 8. And happily ever
heaving,
after
I
is on
you,
it.
It's
yeah,
heaving.
Happily ever after is on at 9. So all the crowds are gathering. It's very chaotic. They're all gathering so they can be in their spots to get a good view of the castle for Happily Ever After. So we're following like little secret shortcuts you can take where everyone else is then like, you know, blocked off in a way. So we're going this way to cut across to Tomorrowland so we can make our way over to Tron. But yes, it's so busy. Woo! The people mover, that's Witchley Grub's all-time favourite ride. I'm just following him. Are you excited?
155 and we're 156.
Woo! And there we go. Astro Orbiter. We were here before, but it looked a lot different, darlings. We're getting closer.
This is it.
Ooh. This is it. We're getting there. Tron is a brand new ride for us that we've never been on.
Never been on.
They do have one in Shanghai.
and then they decided to replicate it and bring one here. So we're about to get into the virtual lane.
Oh my god,
first time riding it is going to be at night, which I've heard is the better time to ride it because of all the lighting. So very, very excited.
Looks like it says Tron there.
I'll show you.
Whoa, look at this. It's very futuristic, very Tomorrowland. Tron Lightcycle Run. The way it all lights up. And it also goes over there as well. Doesn't that look really cool? I feel like we have definitely stepped into the future, darlings. We've watched some of the Tron films as well, so we shall hopefully understand going into the grid. Oh, I can hear it coming. Whoa, look at it. It's going round and the lights follow it on the ceiling. That's so cool. Oh, Amelia's going to do cartwheel. Yeah, you did it. Whoa. Wow. I hear everyone screaming, hopefully with excitement. Isn't it so cool? Wowzers. Oh, I've never been here before in my life. It's very good. Very fun. I love doing things that are new. Thanks, Disney. Whoa. It's gone orange. It's gone orange. So you get orange, blue, and sometimes white. Woo! I'm so excited. These are the seats that we're going to be in. So they're like bikes. You sit there and these will come down at the back. Push down, you basically lie forward with your hands here. You're like leaning forward on a bike from the future. Welcome, Team Blue. That's us, Team Blue. Whoa, we were just in there and we got digitized and then the glass wall went see-through and it revealed the grid to us. And this is it. Whoa. Oh, it starts off like rock and roller coaster. Whoa, that's the reaction. It's so futuristic. I love that you can see that big. So this isn't where you get on it. This is just part of the ride. Just shows you how fast. So fast. And it's going to go outside. Oh, it's awesome. Yeah, we were like in there, the other side of it. And then all of a sudden went see-through. Very clever technology. Woo! Right, time to say goodbye because I have to put you in the locker. So I'm going to put my bum bag and my phone in the lockers here. There's loads of lockers there. They're completely free. You have to put all loose articles, bags, etc., either with someone who's not riding or in a locker. Free to use, and then you'll come back and get it after. So bye bye for now. The next time I see you, I will have been on Tron. Oh, yes, show us how to do it.
What number do you want to be?
Oh, wait there.
Let's be 463. Magic band. Oh, yes. Open it up and we're in, and then we'll use our magic band to lock. Very clever. Bye bye. I'm going on Tron now. In the sky. Let's review what we thought of it.
Oh my god, it was so good.
It was so good. It's coming back.
There it is. It was so good.
I knew that you obviously like, you kind of rode like a motorbike, but you really are like on all fours, leaning forward, yeah. Like almost lying forward, which is a position I've not done before on a ride. It's like really good. Whoa. It's very,
I don't know if you've heard the heroes.
And we're after. Really going off.
It is.
Oh, that was epic. It's so good with all the lighting and just the
fact. My only criticism is it could be a like quarter bit. Oh, it's going to go bang. A quarter bit longer.
Yeah, I
but
think.
But like, it was insane.
I think everyone's got the same opinion that it's really, really good. It is very, very short, but it's very, very thrilling.
And also, we just walked on, which was really good.
Yeah.
There was no queue
at all. Just walking on. Yeah. Really good. Let me show you the fireworks. there you go. I've never seen Happily Ever After from this view. I can't even see the castle. Where is the castle? I don't even know. But this is just going off here. What epic view we got. I can't even hear the Happily Ever After music. Wow, amazing. So we're with Tron. Whilst watching the fire, oh there he is. Look, I don't know if you're allowed to stand on the benches, so sorry Disney if you're not allowed. But he's there, watching Happily Ever After without the music. Awesome, awesome day and an awesome way to finish it off. Isn't it good, Richard Club?
Yeah.
Oh, so from Tron, there's a sign here that says Storybook Circus with arrows. So if you go this way and go down that path, you'll go like underneath Tron and it'll take you to where, back to where Dumbo is. That Storybook Circus, you can go all the way around there. I did see that there's this here. Is there a menu out front or anything? Oh yes, I think it's all closed now, actually.
You can
energy
get
bites.
Watermelon, cucumber and pineapple.
Oh, you can't see very well.
Topped with sweet chilli sauce and furry cake.
Yeah.
Watermelon slushy with yuzu, citrus, ginger and popping candies.
Why is it so dark?
Blue coconut featuring flavours of coconut, lemon and lime. And a cucumber lime soda featuring flavours of cucumber, lime and Sprite over ice.
Oh, you're reading it here. That's where you got the information. I thought you're so...
I suppose it's so dark because they don't open it at night, so therefore they
don't
need
a light. I wonder if it lights up from the back normally.
But this one doesn't either.
Yeah, so...
I wonder if they're closed at night and therefore they don't need a light.
Yes, so not sure. I'm going to head on this way. People move there. Hello, darling. And go around this way. We're making our way out of the park. Well, we're heading out of the park. Happily Ever After finished, I don't know, maybe half an hour ago. It's, yes, it's very, very busy. But I still love the evening atmosphere here on Main Street, USA. Look how pretty the castle looks. Goodbye, Cinderella Castle. We will see you again another night. Well, yes, we're heading on out, and now we've got to get our magical boat that takes us back to Fort Wilderness, because of course we didn't park at the Magic Kingdom parking lot. We parked at Fort Wilderness Lodge, so now we've got to get back there. I'm excited to see Seven Seas Lagoon at night. Yay! We've made it out the front all fine, and Wichita Group has found us, well, taken us to Boat Dock 1 Resort Launches. And now we follow the sign here that says Disney's Wilderness Lodge, Artist Point Restaurant and Whispering Canyon Cafe. We went in the Whispering Canyon Cafe to find the fireplace so that we could find Hidden Mickey, so we know where that is. Right, and luckily, look, there's not really a queue at all. We're just going to walk on.
And interestingly, people are still entering the park.
Still going in?
Yeah, oh, loads. Well, there's a queue to get in.
It doesn't close until 11.
No, there's still
and
a
now's
while.
The perfect time to go in.
All
and
the rides
just,
that you want to go on.
Yeah, like 5 minute wait times.
Although it was 45 minute wait for Space Mountain. Just now it was 45 minute
wait.
Was it?
Yeah, which just took a photo of me outside the front because I'm wearing Space Mountain like it's written on my t-shirt. Yeah. So I went to
all those people on Liberty Bell. On the river boat.
Oh yeah, let me use on my Liberty iPhone
Bell.
Zoom.
Funny looking Liberty Bell, honey.
Yeah, it's... very busy.
Oh, this is my boat. I knew it was somewhere. The luxury boat, yeah.
Oh, we normally like rent boats like this and go on the water. They're very nice. But yes, there's no boat here yet. Oh, I can see. I wonder if these little ones with the lights on. Yeah, a few floating around. But look, we're definitely going to get on the next one that comes in. So that's... it feels very luxurious. Oh, yeah, it's whizzing around. Cute. Our beautiful boat at night is here. Oh, monorail. And it's also the same... driver, pilot, captain of the ship, whatever she's called, sailor of the ocean, sailor of the Seven Seas Lagoon. It's the same lady that we had before, so she's had a long day. But yes, we're going to get on our private boat, darlings. We made it. We are back. We have a sleeping Florence, a very sleepy Amelia. I'm not sure if she's fallen asleep too. But yes, it's very peaceful. It's very lovely here, isn't it, Wichita?
It's lovely.
We're back at Wilderness Lodge, but you can't really see it. Look, it really is the wilderness. Well, it's 10:05. The lifeguards are still on duty and people are still swimming here at Fort Wilderness Lodge.
Guys, the party don't stop here at Fort Wilderness Lodge. Here we are in Florida.
The party just don't stop.
Non-stop party at Fort Wilderness Lodge, baby. It's very dark and moody and romantic and calm and peaceful and wildernessy. That's the word, right? Yes, it's very nice and it feels like home, although it's not. We have to go back to the villa. Well, that's it. We're back at Fort Wilderness. We're going to get in the car. We're going to travel back to the villa. Thank you for joining us on what has been a very adventurous day.
Very adventurous.
I thought we were just going to go around the hotels, but I did not know we were going to go Magic Kingdom. I didn't know we were going to do the Country Bear Musical Jamboree for our first time.
We do not know.
And I didn't know we were going to go on Tron Lightcycle Run for our first time.
Yeah.
What a day! And you saw glimpses of Tink flying off the castle.
Oh, I
in
did.
Happily Ever After. He caught the end of that as we came off Tron.
I ran.
The bikes got off.
From
ran
Tron,
off.
I ran. I got about the last 4 minutes. Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh,
he
did so great. Well done,
boys. Thank you.
I don't know if you can see that on camera, but
yay. Oh, I think Katie must have taken the we didn't get a chance to take all of our hidden Mickey forms.
No.
From the hidden Mickey hunt over to reception, so she must have done that since we got back. And now we've got
more prizes.
Yay. If you're not a subscriber, then please do subscribe, hit that bell icon, turn on your notifications to make sure you don't miss any of our updates. We are here for 3 weeks, baby. If you like the video, please give me a thumbs up. It'll mean the world. Also, I am on Instagram at Wussey_. And if you want to drop me a comment on YouTube, then please do drop me a comment somewhere below. I'd love to hear from you. Any questions, any recommendations, anything at all, that'd be brilliant. I am looking forward to tomorrow because I don't have to use my iPhone anymore because I can get my actual vlogging camera back. Make sure all of my batteries are charged properly this time.
Wussey will make sure.
Yeah,
and Richard Eagle will check.
Yes, I am a little bit worried. I hope that the footage has come out all right. So if it has been, I don't know if it's going to be blurry or if actually it would be better quality, because it is a new iPhone.
I just don't think the selfie mode will be the best quality, but
yeah,
we'll see.
I've been filming a lot of
like me now,
this
I'm
in
not
selfie
sure
mode,
the
so
if I'm
at. No idea. So
we'll
the audio,
see.
Yeah, if there's been a change
we'll
in
see,
audio
we'll
quality,
see.
We'll see. Wussey. Yeah, so apologies if it's been bad. It's only been for today. Back to normal filming quality
indeed.
From tomorrow. All right, guys, that's it. Oh, can't do this with this. Bye, guys, from me, Wussey, and
Richard.